In this example, we have a block of mass 6.3 kilograms is in limiting equilibrium on a rough horizontal plane as attached to a string which is inclined at an angle of 15 degrees to the horizontal. The frictional force acting on the block is 2 newtons per kilogram. Find the tension in the string and the magnitude of the normal reaction. What happens to the normal reaction if the string becomes horizontal and the tension is the same? Now you can see in this question I've just put in, I've already written this in and highlighted, that limiting equilibrium is when the body is on the point of moving. So basically when the forces are balanced. So the forces up equal the forces down, the forces left equal the forces right. So, and also, if it's on the point of moving, your friction is acting at its maximum value. Okay, we're going to go ahead, we're going to draw our diagram for this question. So for our diagram, just do your horizontal line as best as you can, and the mass was 6.3 kilograms. So you've got your mass of 6.3, your weight of 6.3 g newtons going downwards. You've got your normal reaction, R, going upwards. You've got your tension in your string, T, and it is 15 degrees. And the resistance was 2 newtons per kilogram. So 2 times 6.3 gives you 12.6 newtons. So that's your resistance. Okay. To do this, we'll get rid of, scroll down a wee bit so we just see our diagram. To do this, we're going to first of all define your, we're going to resolve vertically and see what we can get. Now in this one, I'm not actually going to find my, I'm going to do this, and it probably, it's going to, in actual fact, it would be better for me to do it the other way, but I'm just going to show you what happens, because quite often you'll do it one way, and it doesn't quite work for you, it doesn't quite allow you to get the question, the answer. But it doesn't matter. So if you go vertically, you've got R plus T sine 15 going up. Going down, you have 6.3 G. So what you have is your R plus T sine 15 is equal to 6.3 times G, which is 10, so equals 63, dot, 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 equation 1. So if I've got one equation with two unknowns, so I can't do anything else with this. What we'll do then is resolve horizontally. Going to right, I have t cos 15. Going to left, I have 12.6, which means t is equal to 12.6 divided by your cos 15. So t works out to be, and I've got given it to a whole pile of decimal places, 13.0444. And it does go on. So what we can do with that is sub it back into your first equation. So sub that back into equation 1. So sub into equation 1, and then you've got R is equal to 63 minus, so it brought the T across, and it was, the T was 13.0444, and then times your sine of 15, and press equals and see what you get for your R. And what I got for my R was 59.6238, and my last line, what I would do is give both of those things to two decimal places. So for my answer, T is equal to 13.04 newtons. That was the two decimal places. And my R is equal to 59.62 newtons to two decimal places. Okay, we're going to go back up and look at the question again. It says, find the tension in the string and the magnitude of normal reaction. Done that, and then it says what happens to the normal reaction if the string becomes horizontal and the tension is the same. So we've got to use the same tension as before. So new diagram here. Tension stays the same. I'll try and make that horizontal. New diagram is still 6.3 kilograms. You've still got 6.3 g newtons. Your R is going this way, and your tension is now going this way, and we're going to use 13.04. It's been a wee bit tricky in this question because it doesn't actually matter about your tension, what it's doing, if it stayed the same or had it changed. Your normal reaction is only looking vertically at these forces, but we'll just put it in anyway and see what we have. So that's, you've got your frictional force, we're assuming is staying the same. That's what you've got. So if you resolve vertically, your R is equal to just 6.3g, so R is equal to 63 newtons. So I think, what was my last R? My last R was 59.62. So my normal reaction has increased. So we'll just say that normal reaction increases to 63 newtons. And also, they didn't ask us about this, but also, we'll just say, also, the body will now accelerate. And according to our diagram, it will accelerate to the right. Okay, so just look at why that is. If you look to the right, you've got 13.04 newtons. To the left, you've got 12.6 newtons. So you've got an overall resultant force going to the right. That's why your body will now accelerate to the right. Okay, so that's us done our video. We have seen how we work with forces being at inclined with our considering friction and considering our normal reactions.